Viewer discretion is advised. Your fave will be criticized.
That's Chris.
That's Shan.
And welcome to CCTV, the Nonstop Pop Show.
And today we will be discussing Card's long-awaited comeback with Ring the Alarm.
If you're wondering who we are, Chris and I have a huge range of experience in the music industry, from performing on stage to working at record labels, so we have a lot of insight into this crazy music industry. And of course, we have so many different discussions about it. And you can come join us in these discussions on Patreon at patreon.com/CCTVPops. And shout out to our CCTV crew members, Lisette, Lily, and Emily. And welcome our newest member, Giancarlo.
Yay, we have an awesome crew. Yes. All
Indeed,
right, so we're talking about Card today, and they are a co-ed group formed by DSP Media, and after a few years away due to member J-Sef enlisting in the military, the group is back with the EP, Re, and the title track, Ring the Alarm, and I'm a big fan of Card, actually, but I think I'm actually more of a fan of the concept itself, like the co-ed aspect, the kind of reggae dancehall inspiration. More than the actual songs themselves. I still really love like the first few singles, like Oh Na Na, Don't Recall. But then it kind of got a little noisy for me. Like the last releases weren't great for me. But I think they have a great, unique niche in the K-pop world. So I am excited that they're back. Right. But yeah, what do you think of Card?
Likewise, I didn't realize how much I liked them until we were going through like the script for this, and I thought, oh wow, I remember this video, and oh my god, I know a lot more, and you know, I was just wishing for a lot of things in their hiatus. I mean, you had BM with his solo stuff that wasn't exactly like, you know, I guess groundbreaking, but it was nice for him to kind of find his artistic, sow his wild oats, if you will, in that sense. You know, Jiwoo was doing her shows with singing, and Somin was doing her influencer thing, so they kept busy while they were away. But you're right, I do kind of miss that they had the whole dance hall sound, and dance hall is let's say K-pop hall, because this is not exactly complete dance hall.
Inspire,
dance hall
covers, inspire.
Yeah, right? Exactly. Yeah. And it's interesting that they have this concept, because it's crazy to hear like groups like Tribe B, even Alexa doing, you know, Baile Funk and all these other Afrobeat inspired or Caribbean beat inspired things. And it's just like they had, I guess, started something that is now super big in K-pop. And it's crazy how they almost abandoned it for the sake of sounding like everyone else when they are older, they're more mature. So they could have just kept kind of riding the wave. There's so much in tropical sounds that you can kind of explore, which is why I'm glad that they're back and back to their roots. And even they knew like, hey, we have to redo a lot of things and go back to the start, which is why I'm really excited to talk about Ring the Alarm, because it is time for Is It Boppin'?
This is It Boppin'? Here, we listen to the song and discuss the production, lyrics, video, and everything in between. So let's find out, is it a bop or a flop? So Ring the Alarm was done by Benjamin, Lee Hyun Sung, TM, Cosmic Girl, Kim Do Hoon, and members BM and J-Sef. And I know a lot of these writers are known for working with Mamamoo. I saw some EXO credits in there, some Rain credits in there. So yeah, a big range right there, which is cool. But let's talk about the song itself first. What do you think of the production and the melody and everything?
Oh, well, the bass line is definitely a highlight for me. I think the one in the beginning sets up the song nicely. It sounds cool and mature, and the siren use is not that typical bwah, 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 that you might hear like in a lot of... I mean, if you are Black and you have your radio turned to like 107.5, there's always a late night dance hall thing. And there's one guy named Davin Levy or something like that. You know, we'd be rocking you. Like, it's just, that siren is always played. So I'm very glad that they didn't use it. but yeah, it really sets the grown and sexy scene well with that bass line. Overall, the production isn't like crazy, which I appreciate, because I think we're so used to like K-pop being just overly dynamic. The dynamism, is that dynamics was the word we decided to use?
Dynamism, but
The dynamism. It goes up and down, and oh, here's a random genre that shouldn't have been in there. So I think this was really interesting. The rim taps and like the drums and the rim taps in the first verse turn into trap drums into the second verse, which I like. There's a filter, like an effect on a guitar and the xylophone plucky sounds. Glockenspiel, if you will. I don't know what you want to call it. But it makes there's like an effect on those instruments that make it sound a lot more round and keeps things really fresh and help connect that island style. And in the chorus, there's like these brassy swells that I like. So there's a lot of little moments where I thought, oh, that was nice. Or, ooh, I like that. Or, ooh, what kind of effect did they use? That sounds like it's underwater. It makes it sound cool. I will say, like, the parts that really kind of got me like, oh, come on. Even when the vocals came around, we'll talk about that a little bit later, was like the bridge. It has like this fun pluckiness that sounds like an African-inspired rhythm. And then there's some tension that is built in the latter half with the synth strings. And then it explodes into the silence, which makes me wish that something else vocally would have been put there that Soman could have just delivered. And also, I feel like toward the end, I would have loved a rhythmic switch up or something more fun, energetic toward the end as like a surprise. And I know it's very K-poppy to do that, but that would have kind of, I guess, just elevated the song, at least so they can party out and kind of just do something a little bit more dance heavy, since the choreography didn't really do a lot of like acrobatics. For those who can't see me, I just did some weird tutting. But yeah, I think overall it's not bad. It's actually pretty solid and nothing was too disjointed where I was like, oh, what's happening? So it flowed really nicely, but nothing really like blew my mind. What about you?
Yeah, I agree. I think the whole thing is very like easy listening, tropical song for like a nighttime pool or beach moment, right? That's like what I get from this. So I like that it wasn't too noisy, it wasn't too crazy, but at the same time, it wasn't too generic either. Like you said, there are some interesting moments in there. I definitely was a little worried having a song called Ring the Alarm that they would go overboard with the alarm sounds. But luckily, it's very subtle. It's very, very subtle, which is great.
Agreed.
Thank the Lord for that. And yeah, I think they did a good job arrangement-wise this time, taking advantage of having the four different voices, the two male, two female, all the different tones and stuff. We'll talk more about the vocals later, but I think just arrangement-wise, I appreciated all the overlapping and just the use of the four, because I feel like in previous songs at times, it felt like the boys were like almost rapper features, or that it felt like, I don't know, it just didn't feel like a group. And this one actually felt like a group, which I appreciate. And then mentioning the bridge, I like the double bridge. I actually like that it kind of goes to the almost silence into the last chorus.
That's cool.
Yeah.
The silence is cool. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. And I actually liked the outro. I understand where you're coming from with the, like a switch up. But again, going back to the easy listening beach pool situation, I wouldn't want that. That would be distracting. So I think the way it built was just enough, actually. And yeah, I will say the song has grown on me quite a lot just through the day. The first time I listened to it, I was kind of like, all right, like that was fine. But now I'm like, okay, yes,
yeah,
I'm into it.
Totally.
So that's good. That's what you want in a pop song, that it grows and you don't get bored of it. Let's go on to the vocals. Let's talk about the boys first. We could split it up. What did you think of how they did?
Oh yeah, so the guys, they don't sound bad. Okay, so I'm thinking about like when they first started, they definitely have maintained a lot of the habits, if that's the word I want to use here, or like the vocal production
stylistic
that they've done before. Yeah, sure. Thank you. Thank you so much. Yeah, that's the word I'll use there. Because stylistically speaking, you always get Jacef with a double, with an effect on the doubled voice or other, I keep forgetting, but there's always like this when he's talking or when he's singing. It's always a filter on his voice. And then BM always sounds very much throaty.
Yes.
And he always kind of sits back here as opposed to bringing it forward, you know, kind of like, and his delivery with certain raps, especially when it's him trying to be cheeky and kind of schmexy, it doesn't come across as schmexy. It just comes across as like a cute like guy kind of approaching you, but like he just sounds like, hey, you know, I'm trying to take you out and spin this bag on you, as opposed to like, listen, I'm trying to talk to you really quickly. So like the delivery wasn't all the way there for me. But certain times when they're like like, you know, him kind of shouting like the little lines in between Somin and Jiwoo's vocals, that's where it's okay. You know, the bridge, that's where it's okay.
Yeah.
I think he needs to switch up vocally what he's doing. Maybe he's not trained to kind of sit in that or rap in that lower bassier tone where it sounds a lot more dry and more raspy. I'm not sure if he's there yet for that, but I just wish he would take advantage of that. And Jason, oh my God, thank goodness. For the past couple of raps, I guess based on the songs that they've had, he's been writing these very awkward kind of raps, I guess just to kind of differentiate himself, to distinguish himself from the other rappers in K-pop. But this one is actually pretty good. His are hit or miss, but this one was actually pretty hit. I like that he actually has some of the Spanish lines and he had the English ones, and it sounded really nice. And I do appreciate that even though he is not like the like a lead vocal, he is considered like the quote unquote ace because he does the dancing, he does the rapping, he does the singing, and you can hear that since he's not throughout the whole song, he does provide background vocals for harmonies and such, like lower harmonies. But yeah, again, if he wrote his rap, he definitely has improved. How did you feel about the guys?
Yeah, I definitely agree with you about everything you said about the guys. I will say this time around, Jaysef's flow was very good. I like that he sounds more relaxed and loose, especially compared to BM, because that throaty thing, I do think is a stylistic choice. I think that that's him making a sound for himself. It's not my favorite,
right.
But it's a choice for sure.
Yeah.
But he can definitely explore other sounds. But I definitely agree that where it does work is the chorus, for sure. Mm-hmm. So there is a place for it, maybe just not for his full verse. Yeah.
Agreed.
Yeah, what did you think of the girls then?
You know, the girls, I enjoy the girls. They're solid. I mean, Somin is definitely a K-pop vocalist. You know, she has really crystal clear kind of vocals. And she really is like the ear candy for this group because everyone else has a darker tone. She is the idol vocal that they absolutely need because they don't even have that in the boys. Like, none of the guys sound like an idol vocal. And her falsettos soften out like the harsher tones presented by BM or like Jiwoo, especially in the bridge. And you have Jaysef kind of smoothing it out as well with his harmonies. And Jiwoo has an alluring tone. And this past like hiatus for the group allowed her to grow. She had that Good Girl series and she's been doing some performances. So she sounds really strong. I mean, that and how old she's become, you can hear the maturity and like she doesn't sound so like... like she's pushing as much. She doesn't sound like she's reaching. Excuse me.
Yeah.
I think she and Somin are definitely the sweet and sour, spicy, sweet thingy. They just balance each other out really well, like the hot and cold. I do wish that there would have been like not even a belt, but like a oh yeah, the kind of for that last chorus because there's silence there and it kind of just goes yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And then the chorus comes back around. And I'm like, no, this is where you go, yeah, oh, oh, oh. That's where she's not belting, but just something to kind of be like, hey, we have a vocalist in our group.
Yeah.
You know, just to kind of keep the energy high. You can still have a good time at a pool party. I mean, there's a lot of things going on in the pool. I needed that moment where she's like, yeah. Maybe not that high, but like just something just to give it a little bit more of a.
Yeah, I do agree with that. We know they can do that also.
I just
want to say the only thing I can really add to that, I love Jiwoo's tone. I love that she can sing lower and it still sounds really strong. That is sorely lacking in many K-pop girl groups, I think. It's like a Carmeet, right? In Pussycat Dolls. Like, you need that huskier, deeper tone to balance it all out. So I just love the dynamic between the two women in here. And I think it always works well. Overall, like I mentioned, I liked that they actually felt like a group this time. You did mention there are some harmonies in there, but I think there could have been more harmonies in there. especially when the couples are kind of singing. I know they're not couples, but you know what I mean? Like when they were switching off
duos.
Like the duos. For the bridge, that could have been a much cooler moment than it was.
Yes.
In terms of the way they would layer it, and then it could have built into the four of them singing together. I think that would have been really fun. So that's the only thing I'm missing. But the fact that it already feels more cohesive, I think, is a good step. So I'm hoping it leads to that.
I agree. I mean, just to kind of just shout out what you were saying, I mean, even if they did it in something in tandem, the way like a IM and Juhan does with their raps in the bridges usually, it kind of just adds, especially when the music's swelling, because not all the time do you have someone that's going to belt, but if you have some energy to kind of carry it, But yeah, I agree with you, which also kind of goes back to, brings me to like the lyrics. I know that was a weird kind of segue, but I wanted to kind of mention it. I feel like lyrically, the song was building as well.
Yeah.
And we just didn't get it like in the sense of like vocals toward the end, which is kind of, I'm not going to let it go. The ending, I just wanted something more. But yeah, no, lyrically, I feel like this song is interesting. It has like two meanings where it's like, you know, ring the alarm, we're back. But also very simple, like, hey, you're hot, I'm hot, come here,
yep.
Come dance with me. Because, I mean, if you look at like Jiwoo's lyrics, she says something about like, you know, say goodbye to 19. She debuted when she was like 19, 20. And then, of course, being 19, that's that age of like sexy time, apparently in Korea, like that rating when it comes out. That's what it means. So it's just like, it has a double meaning of her, like, I'm trying to get sexy, but also, hey, I debuted at 19. We're re-emerging again. Oh, that's what re-emerging is, baby. So we're re-emerging as a group. And then even like her good girl line refers kind of just back to, yeah, I can be a good girl, I can be a bad girl, but also to the show she did. And again, back to BM's lyrics, his vocal delivery just made... They weren't as cringy, like dripping like faucet, but I just don't like that he said something about like the sauce and eat someone
the
like
entree.
An entree. It was just so awkward. If he was whisper rapping, that would have kind of elevated them a little bit more. But because he was like, it just didn't.
Agreed. Yeah, those lyrics in particular are quite sexy, but then because he's singing it like a frat bro, it's just kind of like,
Sorry, yeah. Again, but not as cringy as usual. But yeah, Soomin and BM had the really generic, like, hey, I'm hot, you're hot lyrics. But then Jiwoo and Jason had like these deep meaning in their lyrics. It was so funny because I was like, these are the pensive ones. But it sounded nice for the most part. Nothing too crazy. Where I was like, what is that random English? And even in the bridge, it was like, you know, it was them as a group. Like, we're here, we're back, we're hot. I like that part. So again, nothing too crazy, nothing too random. I appreciated it. It was classy. What did you feel about it?
Yeah, I mean, I think they're fun overall. Mm-hmm. They fit kind of the vibe of the song. I will just say, kind of in relation to the deep lyrics versus not deep lyrics, though, it is very funny reading the translation. Because I've mentioned this a few times, but when Korean lyrics get translated into English, they just always sound so deep and poetic. And so it's just funny seeing the juxtaposition between BM's very kind of sexual ones, the very kind of literal sexual ones, and then J-Sep's like very poetic ones mixed in with the random Spanish words as well. It's funny for sure. So what did you think of the video? Again, I tried to not watch it. I made myself listen to the song first a few times. Right. What did you think of the visual?
It was a little random in certain parts.
Yes.
But I think this was more of a like harkening back to other visuals that they've had, like in, you know, an amalgamation of like Oh Na Na, Red Moon, Dumb Litty, Bomb Bomb. Because a lot of these visuals, I'm like, oh, wow. I remember the flower crown that she wore, that Soomin wore. And I think it was like Bomb Bomb. I'm like, oh my gosh, here she is wearing a red nair. And then in Red Moon, she's in a red room. Or they all were in a red room. She's in a red room now, sitting on a heart. You have BM climbing a mountain. During his solo thing, he was talking about struggle. And then he's almost like the one who was holding it down a little bit, like musically for the group, as well as Jiwoo, who kind of was in her crystal room that she was in for Dumb Litty. Like, there's a lot of things that kind of go back to who they were, but also showing you who they're going to be with the white room with the columns. And that watercolor splash in the back, where it's like, we still have more to show you, but, you know, we're going to clear off the canvas and kind of start fresh. Not clear it off, like paint it white, whitewash the canvas, but leave a little bit of color so you know what you're working with. You know something's going to come. We're going to dissect and pick from that and bring the best foot forward. So, you know me out here dissecting.
Yes, I'm so glad you're able to analyze these so much better than I am, because I don't know Card's discography that well, and so I did not know that they were references to their old videos. I was just like, I do not get it. Like, why is Like, the solo scenes made no sense to me. I was like, why is BM climbing this, like, fake mountain versus, like, Somin in the aquarium thing? Like, I just was confused. I liked a lot of the scenes. Like, they looked good, but it just did not make sense to me at all. So that if that is the case, that that makes more sense for sure. But I will say, just performance-wise, that they do... they do look a lot better than in their first few videos. Just charismatically and stage or video presence-wise, camera presence-wise, it's much more natural, all four of them. And I liked that they all looked like they actually were really in it. Like, they all looked very excited and dedicated to be there the whole time, which is good, because I feel like a lot of the K-pop videos, we do get that kind of blank look, and I get that that's a thing. We did mention that in our Kepler video, but I don't like the blank faces. I prefer some fire with it under the eyes, in the eyes, and they all have that for sure, which is great.
Oh my god, yes, they look so good. Well, shout out to the girls again. Jiwoo, Somin. Oh my god, Jiwoo has like that CL charisma. Mm-hmm. And then Somin smolders. Like, they, again, this group is very much hot and cold. Like, they have a good balance, and the dynamic between everyone is good. You know, you have BM, who's a little bit bigger and kind of comes across a certain way. He's great with Somin, who's like kind of classy, sexy. And you have Jiwoo, who's like cool, kind of like tsundere type, like he's cold. And you have Jaesip, who's a little bit more warm, but he has a very fierce face. Like, everyone kind of just makes sense. And even when they switch off, it's like, oh, that looks good together too. Like, it's just,
visually, they look really good together. Individually. So if this was just a ploy just to like be a visual group and get more brand or fashion partnerships or whatever, it worked, I think. Like, they look good.
A ploy. I love that word. Go off. Speaking of ploys, there's no ploy. That was a weird kind of, I'm totally joking. But no, I was, but seriously, speaking of ploy though, I think their whole concept with like doing dance hall and stuff like that is interesting, because now they're going back to it. It's like, how can they like reinvent the wheel? Because the wheel has been spun off in all these different kind of versions. And it's so interesting to see them dance now, which brings us to our choreography section. Because it's just like, that was your thing for a while. That was the ploy from the company to make you guys come across as different. But now you have to compete with other people doing exactly what you're doing and adding even more rhythms and all this other stuff. How did you feel about the performance, the choreography? Like, is it better? Is it worse?
I think it's in line with their older stuff, more so the first. Again, I know the first few singles way better than the later ones. So it's in line with like the Don't Recall and that kind of thing. I will say a lot of it is very kind of just dance hall 101. And that's not necessarily a bad thing, because it does look fun to do. They're clearly having fun doing it. And it fits the song. It's just hard, I think, because we have mentioned in the past that K-pop choreo is so difficult. So I actually appreciated that this one is not that difficult. They can sing live while doing it. They won't be super out of breath by the end of it. And it looks fun, right?
Yeah.
But then I think when you do something simple, then you have to execute it super, super well. And so I'm not sure that they're fully there with that. But again, if they're just trying to have fun, then it was great, I guess. Also, though, I will say a lot of it did remind me of a lot of exercises we used to do in dance classes and rehearsals and things, where you'd have to do the same moves and you'd have to either make them more masculine or more feminine based on, just like how you would perform it, right? So that's very common in commercial dance, because different artists will want different things from their dancers. But this was funny watching this, because especially watching the guys, because there's a lot of hips in this choreo. And so watching them like not move it too much, or like really keep their abs very stiff during it so that they're not being too feminine with it. It was just funny to see that, because I have definitely had to like work on that as a dancer. What did you think?
As soon as you said I had to work on that as a dancer, I thought about me when I was going through my whole like, I want to dance more mask. So I was doing a lot more shoulders.
Yes. That's really what it is. It's shoulders and chest versus hips. That's usually hips. What it is. Yeah.
That's amazing. Sorry, I just had a moment. I really just thought about it. That's why I threw my head back and laughed like that. So yeah, it is interesting to see the ebb and flow of each. Because I was watching them and I started giggling too, because it's just one of those things where dance hall is it a pocket in it within a pocket within another pocket. It's not just like, let me hit it, you know. You have to dance through the movement and you have to wave at the same time. You have to slowly undulate at the same time. It's never just a simple thing. Even with the simple steps, like, you know, willy bounce here and there, or maybe like, you know, or the ponytail or whatever, you still have to kind of hit your mark and then bring it back. And like, there's a lot of like pulling and pushing. It's very like rubber bandy. And even when they first started doing it, I've always looked at it like, oh my God, this is like some... Like, I've never offended. I'm not Jamaican or, like, Caribbean, but I always was like, oh, this is very much, like, K-pop style. You know, it's, very, like, implanted dance hall as opposed to, like, them getting someone like a Tina Mirae. By the way, shout out to Tina Mirae from our interview. You know, check that out, y'all, if you haven't seen it. But, yeah, instead of getting someone who's, like, Black or someone who is trained in it and getting them to show them, they have someone who maybe learned it and then teaches it to the groups. Mm-hmm. It's not bad, but then you have that combination of K-pop dancing, or you have that combination of like cool TikTok dance, like the SMEs, where they hop and shake their shoulders at the same time while all of a sudden it's going into this weird body roll, and it just doesn't make sense. And that's why I kind of get a little annoyed. It's not their fault, obviously. It's just one of those choreography things where I'm just like, come on, you don't have to put trendy moves. The moves become trendy because you are the one doing it and making it look good, right? So that weird amalgamation of K-pop, trendy, and dancehall is a little bit weird. And I would love to see what would happen if they ever get a chance to kind of just do like a kind of like a generic kind of maybe like bass heavy, just K-pop style dance. I want to see if they can perform it a little bit better, because sometimes their core or like their center is just not there for some of these roles. But you know what? They try to make it fit toward their body, and I really do appreciate that. BM doesn't look like, you know, a big bear dancing, because he has a very crump oriented kind of, just the way he is, he looked like he would excel in crumping, you know, so things like that. Mm-hmm. Nothing that would require a lot of like small detail. Jaseb dances like he's from second gen still. I don't know what that is. Somin has that K-pop in her. I mean, she was in that little baby Kara group. And then Jiwoo, she knows what works for her. And I've never really looked at her and been like, oh, what the hell is she doing? Because she's like, I'm not going to do too much. Here's a cute little hip. I'm not going to do too much. You know, she's been kind of safe for the most part. But overall, I think they look good. They have chemistry. Even when they're dancing for their group part, they smile at each other. Because it's like, how can you not laugh, right? Like, how can you not laugh when you're like, I'm going to dance and kick your feet. And like, you know, it's cute. So I enjoy watching them. And it makes me kind of forget that they're doing K-pop dance hall. K-pop hall. But overall, I'm actually really cool with it.
Yeah, I agree. Just mentioning the chemistry, we had talked about chemistry in our Kepler Up review that just came out, if you want to listen to that also after this. Yeah. But yeah, this is what we mean when it feels like genuine chemistry, because even if those smiles are technically planned, they don't feel planned. And they actually seem like they want to be there and they want to be dancing with each other. So that's what we mean. So yeah.
Yes.
They did a great job with that. All right. So what do you rate this song?
Oh my God, this is so hard because I'm trying to base it on other old stuff.
Yeah.
But it's an upgrade from their middle, like their second phase.
Yes.
Okay. I'm going to give it a 7.5. How do you feel about the track?
I will give it an 8, I think. Yeah. It's a good start for the return. all right. So this is the return. So what do you hope is next for Card?
Honestly, the EP was okay. I listened to it. This was definitely the stronger track out of all of them.
Yes.
But if they decide to do some of their older B-side videos like they did back in the day, where they would have like, that'd be fun. That'd be so fun. I don't mind those, because that's what keeps the fans engaged. That what makes us appreciate the B-sides. I'm not sure if they're going to be able to tour again. Like when they first came out and they had that wild card tour, or was it hidden card tour? I forget. We'll see what happens. I mean, even in the music video, they kind of harkened back to their card suits, you know? So I'm hoping that they maybe kind of introduce that hidden card again. Like they bring a featured artist. I mean, there's so many soloists now that they can actually kind of just bring in, where they don't have to work with groups now. So if they have the funds and if it makes sense, I say they should do more collaborations or even subunit the girls. It blows my mind how you had all this time off and didn't think to put Hot and Cold Girl together. Like, I mean, they would have been great. I would have loved to have seen that. Feature EPs or feature mini albums, definitely do that some more. And I hope this isn't like the last of them getting back to their roots, because there's so many island Caribbean Afro styles I can do. Baile funk, Afro beats, that reggaeton adjacent mumbop. I forgot what it's called. I think it was Mambap. I forgot what it's called. But there's so many different things they could do. But yeah, I'm excited for them. I'm hoping for more. But definitely go back to that earlier stage where you guys brought some randos in. And it was like, oh, that's fun. You know? So
yeah.
What about you? How do you feel?
Yeah, I will say I love a co-ed group. You know, there haven't been enough of them in the world in general. So I'm glad that they're still around and that they've been doing pretty well for themselves. I believe they actually are going on tour. I think maybe only in South America this round. But yeah, I think they are here again for the long term, which is good. So yeah, I think for me, I agree. I hope they experiment with more sounds, with more writers. I think also going back to the co-ed thing, they need people to come in and really take full advantage of the four different voices and male and female voices. You know, there's so many different things you could do, and they haven't taken full advantage of that, I think, throughout their career so far. Like, why not have a song where the girls rap instead? Or, like, have the boys sing together more, you know?
Yeah,
or, I don't know. Yeah. There's so many different ways you can use this dynamic, and I just don't feel like they've fully utilized that.
Right.
So that's, yeah. But I think there's a lot of potential there, and I'm excited for what's next. I think this is a great start. I also gave the EP a quick play, and I enjoyed it as a listen. And so, yeah, I'm just glad that they're back, and they have a great niche in the market for sure.
Yes, totally. So, Wildcard, what do you all think about this track? And let us know your thoughts and comments below, or message us at CCTV Pops on all social media. You can also join us on Patreon. We'd love to get to know you, and you can help us decide our next episode topics. So please give us a like, subscribe to our channel, and hit that notification bell. For our listeners, give us a rating and review on your podcast platform of choice. Until next time, that's Chris.
That's Jan.
And we are CCTV.